Welcome back to Urban Fashionista, and I'm right here with some three pretty people. I want them to tell me their names, who they're wearing. Let me start with this gentleman right here.
I'm a vogue compiler, a fashion stylist, creative stylist, celebrity stylist, wardrobe stylist, personal shopper.
Oh, I'm wearing a vintage retro piece from like a vintage store, so yes, that I've just like tailored, twerked for myself, yeah.
So are you excited to be at the Kampala Fashion Week launch party?
I'm really so excited. I'm really so grateful for this moment. It's a really incredible moment. I'm really enjoying it.
I'm expecting a lot of new designs and a lot of new trends. So I cannot miss, because as a designer, I need to see what my people have, what my other people have. So
yeah, I've been to the previous one. It was really nice, and I'm so excited about this. I can't wait for it.
If you look at fashion right now, especially with a lot of Ugandans, when it comes to design, let's begin with that. Just right there behind me, the Gomez. You saw the lady who came in the Gomez. We've got a lot of people who are giving us the big puffy shoulders. That is already back. We've got the huge belts. That is back.
I will be very truthful. I don't have inspiration from Uganda, but yes, I'm wearing the 1950s. I'm a person that really believes in vintage kind of dressing, and yeah, that's really me.
I'm the founder and executive producer of Kampala Fashion Week, and this year is our fifth edition, and we're just, you know, very excited for the growth of our team and showcasing designers, and yeah, this is the pre-party to kind of just get into the mood.
Independence Week, I think, like, she dressed herself, I dressed myself. This is independence already.
Well, I'm dressed by me. I'm wearing Gajenta, that's my fashion line. Yeah, so I thought I would put something together, and that's what I put.
I look forward to working for every designer. I love walking the runway, you know that.
We've got the belly bottoms coming back. There's a lot of fashion that is coming back. In Uganda, what I love is the fact that we're trying to use a lot of our local materials to actually make our fashion, as opposed to you're now using imported materials and all that.
So I'm from the UK, and I'm based here in Kampala, and I'm challenging people to be more creative in the way that they dress. And basically, men have a very hard time when it comes to putting on colorful clothing. They can't really do it.
It would catch people's eye and be like, wow, who wears a gomesi to a fashion do? And then it hit me, another thing was like, the original gomesi was like sleeveless. So this pop-up, I feel, is a fashion statement. Like, whoever came up with this is really cool, because Gloria Wavamuno herself makes jackets that are popping up like this. So I was like, yeah, for me, let me put it as a fashion thing.
Like every year, if people know Kampala Fashion Week, there's always like a theme kind of direction for everyone, and this direction was kind of a reflection, a self-reflection, and questioning the lightness and darkness of the world. And I felt, and where is the destination with that? And so the railway felt like a good kind of space. It's also their 120th anniversary.
And I love emerging Ugandan designers, a lot of that. And what am I doing with Fashion Week? Supporting what they're doing. Supporting African talent, Ugandan raw talent.
So I am the mentor. I direct and produce the show with Gloria and her team.
Well, I'm going to do what I do best, really. I can't tell you that I'm going to do this or do that, but I'm going to do what I do best, which is designing, and then the crowd will have to vote.
So let's not do what everybody does. Even the Dolce and Gabbana, the Versaces, are always doing a haul or something. This is Uganda, let's go wild. In fact, if we had a giraffe running through the railway, it would have been even better, you know what I mean?
I've been coming here for the past 6 years. So I've been working with Kampala Fashion Week from its inception, and so happy to always come back. It feels like home.
Well, tickets are being sold at Bold. We have seating and we have standing. Seating is at 100K, standing is at 35, but there's a discount with Stanbic. If you use a card to buy your ticket, then it's 90K. What else? Why should they come? Because it is a destination. And if you're looking for or wondering what your destination or are on a journey, I think we can definitely be part of it.
Well, Toto Africa does accessories and then clothes, which is mostly Ankara. What I'm wearing is Toto Africa itself.
This year, we're doing big things with the Seed program. Seed Project happens on Thursday. We have 12 amazing local emerging designers that are going to show fabulous looks, as well as 15 designers on Friday and Saturday. You have to be a part of this. You're going to miss it if you don't come.
Creativity. And when I mean creativity, I don't mean copy-paste. Because we tend, in the fashion world is small, so we tend to copy-paste a lot. I'm looking for some out of the... I mean, the venue is a railway station, for heaven's sake. So I'm looking for out-of-the-world kind of thinking. It doesn't mean I have to wear that outfit to go for an event, but just show out your creativity.
I felt like it was just an overall message of like that we need to go on this journey together and we need to develop ourselves and yeah, see where it goes. So it's just like showing all the different ways that everyone in different departments want to collaborate. We have Patronic Service who are giving us amazing lights, you know, and we have Marembe Musisi who is the head of set design. So
we're very excited this year, Destination Kampala Fashion Week. We're taking everybody to the Kampala Railway Station. I'd like to introduce us to, no, needs no introduction, the fabulous fashionista. What we want to do is, this is somebody that supports Ugandan fashion, African design, contemporary modern fashion, and yeah.
All right. My favorite designers in Uganda. Oh my God, I have many. From bag designers to accessory designers. One, Anita Beryl. I'm gonna give you a lady that so many people do not know. Sharon. Sharon is a crazy lady. I have a lady called Nato Nates. Very beautiful designer. Still young and upcoming.
Definitely. I think generally the nature of Uganda is what has always spoken to me, continues to speak to me, and I definitely want to always continue to send the message that we must take care of the environment as we develop in our structures. Well, this year my collection is called FD, which is fifth dimensional, and it's just my development as a designer where detail is everything to me, and I just wear now I'm taking my detail in simplicity.
I'm planning to challenge men to dress more adventurously. I'm expecting people to be playful in the way that they dress.
Gloria's a creative. And at the beginning of the year, we said, where are we going? She said, we're going to the railway station.
And I chose this outfit because it is a fashion statement, and this is a fashion do. And I feel that we really don't appreciate much of our culture. And we're so embarrassed to, like, you know, be confident and walk out into... I literally want to wear this, like, on a Sunday and just go to church.
Uganda, and, you know, Ugandan architecture, Ugandan style, Ugandan fashion, and where else? A lot of cities don't have this type of architecture, so it's a wonderful venue. We're very happy with the team. They've been excellent. Shout out to KCCA, Kampala Railway Station, and all the designers.